Hey, what's up? Tristan from Huge Menace here. Welcome to part 12 of the Indie Add-on Deep Dive series. In this video, we'll dive into the Utils collection of operators in Indie. Utils and Indie are a miscellaneous operator grouping that makes a few general modeling tasks more efficient. There aren't many of them to go through, so let's jump straight in. First, we have Set Origin. If you're wondering why this operator exists, given that Blender already has several set origin operators, it's because it solves two specific problems that are tedious to perform manually. The first is setting the origin of one object to that of another. Without Indie's set origin operator, you'd need to select the object you want to use as the target origin point, set the 3D cursor at its position, then select the object you want to affect, and from the object menu, choose set origin, origin to 3D cursor. With Indie, select the object you want to affect first, then select the target object whose origin you want to match, and click Set Origin. That saves time and makes it feel more intuitive. The following way to use the Set Origin operator is where its power is really appreciated. Traditionally, setting the origin of an object either generated procedurally or with many utils parented to it can be a bit of a mess. The situation should look familiar if you've watched the Replicate video in this deep dive series, in which we covered this circular array operator. A way to solve this is to first translate the object to the target position so that the two origins match, and then translate the object back to its original position using the displace modifier. I call this the faux origin displacement method. The issue with doing that manually is that you'd need to note down the object's original position and then find the offset from its new position, creating separate X, Y, and Z displacement modifiers to return it to where it started. That whole process can take a few minutes. You can use the set origin operator to save yourself the trouble by holding down the Alt key when choosing it. It'll perform all the steps I mentioned in a fraction of a second. Suppose you no longer want the faux origin displacement. In that case, you can select any object affected by it and shift-click on the set origin operator. This will remove the modifiers while also applying their offsets, effectively moving the object's origin back to where it was. One last feature of set origin is available in edit mode. Select any vertex, edge, or face and choose Set Origin to place the object's origin at the center of the selected geometry. Okay, next on the list is Snap Align. Snap Align lets you quickly snap one object to another at the center of any vertex, edge, or face while copying its rotation. Let's take a look. I'll select this cone object and then the cube I want it to snap to. Then select Snap Align. The cone will now follow my mouse cursor around the cube. Whenever I hover over the center of a face, edge, or vertex, it will snap into place and adjust its rotation accordingly. The object being snapped will be aligned based on its origin. So this cone, for example, has the origin set at its base. But if it were to be at its center, it would snap to the cube but intersect it. So that's worth keeping in mind. Now, an additional feature of Snap Align is Point Capture. This lets you start by capturing one of the points you're hovering over by hitting the C key. You see that the point now draws a line from the captured point to the alignment point on the reference object. You can then find a second point and capture that by once again hitting the C key. The result is that Snap Align will create a new virtual point in the center of the two captured points. This is helpful for more fine-grained alignment or specific cases. All right, finally we have the last operator, Apply Modifiers. This one does what it says on the tin, plus a bit more. At some point in the modeling process, you may want to apply all active modifiers to work destructively or continue poly modeling. Sometimes this is required for more complicated shapes, or simply once your model is complete and you want to perform some final cleanup or begin UV unwrapping. This operator has a few modes, so let's start with its default. Here, I have a cube with a few Boolean operations performed, followed by a bevel. Let's assume I want to adjust the model destructively. Still, I want to avoid applying finishing modifiers like the bevel. Well, I can select it and run Apply Modifiers. By default, it'll apply all non-finishing modifiers, that is, all modifiers present except object bevels, smooth shading, weighted normals, and triangulation. Let's assume I want to apply absolutely all modifiers present. I can do so by running the Apply Modifiers operator and holding down the Shift key, which runs the operator in Hard Apply mode. The third option that Apply Modifiers offers is a version of Hard Apply that duplicates the selected objects and then applies all modifiers. This can be engaged by holding down the Alt key. Okay, and just like that, we've covered all of the util operators. In the following video, I will review the last category, viewport. I'll see you there.